Okay. Hi, hello everyone. So we are here today with Austin Davis for a wonderful workshop of how to think of new board games. I'll shortly introduce him. Austin Davis is a faculty at Toy and Design Department at NID, National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad. He is also an alumni of the same department, after which he has worked professionally as a digital game designer for over 3 years. He has later joined NID as a faculty and has been associated with the department for over 5 years. He holds a strong interest towards the area of culture, play and board games. He is a strong believer of learning through play, and that is what we're going to do here today, I believe, Austin. So I'll hand it over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Sharmishta. Thank you for that introduction. Taking up more time, I'll start with the presentation, during which I'll also explain how we are going to work out this session. So I'll just share my screen quickly. I hope the screen is visible.
Yes, it is visible.
So this workshop, since we have, like, I feel 1.5 hours is like such a short time, and I've been working on board games for so long, for years, and I'm still learning. So I thought that making a full-fledged board game has a lot of involvement, a lot of time, a lot of testing. But something that I thought we could do is to see how you can think of a board game idea, because in so many situations, you ask yourself, I want to make a board game, but how should I start? Where should I start? What should I do? Or, how do I think of a new idea? So I felt maybe that could be one thing that we can target in this workshop. So before we start with thinking of idea, I think it's important that we understand what are the elements of a board game. Broadly, when you think of board game, it has a theme. I think if you, all those who have played board games or have only played a few also, there is always a story or some sort of a setup. Let's take, and when I say theme, it doesn't necessarily mean the visuals that you see on the board game. If you take the game of chess, for example, it has a theme of kingdoms. You have war scenario, you have, an army, you have the entire team of the king with all his supporters, king, queen, skamantri, and, the pawns. Similarly, in Snakes and Ladders, there is a theme of course, the core concept being about good and evil, good versus evil, but as a theme of snakes representing the evil and ladders representing the good, or the good deeds that you do. So theme is one strong aspect of any board game. Again, it is not necessary that every board game or every game should have a theme. It is also possible that you can go ahead and work without having a theme too. The other important, very strong aspect of board games is the mechanic. Now, what is a mechanic? A mechanic in a board game usually refers to the core. You can say the core gameplay. For example, if we take a simple example of Ludo. So the mechanic is that you throw the dice and you move your pawn, and you have to make sure you reach the end. So it is like a race to finish. You have to make sure that all your pawns move through the path and come to the center. So that is the core mechanic. Now, just like Ludo, there are so many games and every game has its own mechanic. So mechanic in itself is like a big study, because there are multiple mechanics that have been documented, well documented and researched over also. Then of course you have rules, which is obvious, I don't think I have to explain. One thing I would like to mention about rules is that a lot of people might take rules, it's very casual, do this, do that. But at the same time, if you have tried to play a complex game so many times, if you are not able to explain the game properly, or you miss out on a certain point, it impacts the experience of the game. And most of the time you won't be able to even you know, enjoy the game the way it is supposed to, you might not be even able to start the game. Because कहीं ना कहीं जाके आप you'll get stuck. कि oh, they have not mentioned what is supposed to be done at this stage. So from that point of view, it is very critical that you are able to write the rules very properly. It is very crisp. It is not like a long book, but you know, to the point, and covers everything that can happen inside the game, so that the players don't get stuck and they should be able to understand the game very easily. And then you have the challenge. Now the challenge is what makes you know, creates structured play. So that sort of the mechanic, the rules. You are supposed to do certain actions in the game in a certain way, and when you have an obstacle in the path, that is where you apply some sort of a skill. You know, it could either be a strategic skill or a physical skill, or maybe you have to, you know, convince someone to do something for you. So depending upon the kind of game, the kind of mechanic, there are different types of challenges that are incorporated into the game. Sometimes these challenges can make you think strategically, or it can be purely luck based, like in Snakes and Ladders. It's purely luck based. It is not under your control what happens, unless of course you are an expert at throwing a die and making sure that one comes if you throw it in a certain way. That is a different level of skill. And then you have the goal. For every game, it is very necessary that you tell them ki boss karna kya hai game mein. Matlab, you need to tell them ki this is your target, that you have to reach to that block first, or you have to collect maximum points, or you have to make sure you are able to you know, complete these puzzles before them. Is it time based? So a goal. So moving on, the $1 million question, where to start? So that is something, even now sometimes when I start working on a project, I will think ki, you know, how should I start thinking of a board game? To be honest, there is no fixed formula. So from my experience, and also being part of some projects, like Shirmusha mentioned, I have worked in the digital game industry. So there is not much of a difference between board games and digital games when it is about planning the gameplay. Somewhere in even in that case, you can follow a same strategy there too, like different approaches that you can take in thinking of an idea. So based on my experience, I thought there are these four key things that you can start off. Of course, you can explore and discover your own strategies and ways to make your own ideas. But these are something that I feel that I can share with you, which might help you to start off and then discover once on your own. So one is once upon a time. Once upon a time is like a starting point of a story. So yes, story. Sometimes a story can be something that can help you think of a new idea. So let's say if you take any digital game that is out there, a lot of digital games, not all of them, but a lot of them are built on stories. Like any role-playing action games, Grand Theft Auto, COD, there's so many, I think everyone has their Prince of Persia, everyone has their own choices. But they are heavily based on the stories that are there in their background. And those stories define what the mechanic, the goal, the challenges and the rules will be. So similarly, in a board game also, like if you take Game of Life, so, you know, there is a narrative that you have to experience living a life, or in Monopoly, you have, you know, the story is that you have to build your own industries. So somewhere that defines what happens in the game. So that leads to other aspects of the game. So that can be a starting point. You can start with a story. On the other hand, you can also start sometimes with a mechanic. So let's again, like in Snakes and Ladders, it's a race to finish. So that is a mechanic. Who reaches first? You throw a die and someone moves. Now that is a concept. Based on that, you make a game. Now that game can have different types of stories. It could be Snakes and Ladders, or it could be like a race between two athletes, you know, a theme, or it could be a theme of like a race between a person who drives a car and a person who drives a bike. So again, depending upon your creativity and whatever crazy idea you have, you want to incorporate. But you start with the mechanic. The mechanic remains constant. That is a race to finish, or similarly, territory capture, or card sorting, or matching. So these are all mechanics. Like I said, there is a immense, matlab, there is immense work done in documenting the different types of mechanics that are there in the game, and there are like hundreds of them. If you go online and just type board game mechanics, you will get very good websites that give you information, even videos that can talk in detail about it. But that can be one, you know, one way of starting with an idea. One is test a skill. Sometimes you might start with the fact that you want like a strategy based game where they have to strategize, or it could be something to do with solving puzzles. You know, you test a skill of being able to solve visual puzzles or physical puzzles. Like if you take a game of Jenga, it is something to do with your skill and your ability to be, you know, to remove a block very slowly so that it doesn't fall down. Somewhere there is also a limit of strategy because you try to select which one should I remove. So, well, most of the times when you make something, it becomes a mix of different things, but there is one skill that becomes a very priority thing in there. So that could be one way to start with thinking of an idea. And the last one, which is a bit more complex and which is something that we do a lot at our department at NID, which is adopt and adapt. You take inspiration from what you see around you. So if you feel that, you know, there are a group of people who love talking to each other or pulling each other's leg, so that could become a starting point for you. Okay, I want to make a game around this. You know, it could be as simple as someone has to pick a card. Suppose I pick a card and I see Sharmisha's name, then I have to pull her leg. And I have to, maybe I'll be given three options, you say one thing. And then she will pick a card, someone else will do that. And maybe everyone votes, whoever has done the best leg pulling, they get maximum points. So similarly, depending upon what you see around you. So that could also be a place to start. So for this session, what we'll do is that I have fixed a template because, you know, the world of board games is like a vast ocean. You know, if I just tell you, okay, think of something and make, I think we'll spend half an hour just thinking ki kya kare. So something to start with, something to anchor yourself to. So there is a template, a fixed layout on which all of us are going to think of ideas. So that will become fixed. And we will discuss about all the four starting points that I just discussed. And we will give like a small amount of time trying to think of an idea through every starting point. And I will give you different challenge for every starting point, small challenges like a brief, so that again we are working in a focused way and you're able to experience how we can go about using these starting points to come up with ideas. Of course, the last is think of an idea. Even though I've written you make, you play and improve, because I have mentioned that here, we might not be able to do that here because the time is very short to be able to play and improve it. Still, we'll see what is possible, but ideally, if ever after this workshop, whenever you go about trying to make a game, make sure you play and don't wait for ki let my game become perfect and then I will test it out with people. As soon as you have a small idea, just take a piece of paper, draw the board, you know, paper ko marod ke chips bana do, you take a dice and just start playing with people, because every time you play, you learn a lot about the game. So we'll see if, I don't know if there are people around you, or maybe sometimes when even I am in a situation where I don't have people to play with, I play with myself. Nonetheless, because it helps in testing out ki how the game is moving, and that is where you're able to find flaws or some issues or something that you can improve. So always do that. Make, play and improve. So this is the template that all of us are going to use. I thought that since this workshop is online, I did not want all of you to, you know, come up with materials and, you know, a certain set of tools and all. So I kept it open-ended. You can either do this on your laptop, or you can just have a piece of paper, a notebook on which you can scribble, maybe click a photo and then upload it. I have decided to go ahead with a grid because it is something that I have, whatever ideas I have made, to give as an example, I made it on PPT itself. So it's as simple as that. So you can just make your ideas and explain it on PPT, on your laptop, or if you want to do work with Photoshop, Illustrator, that is up to you. And if you want to make it on a piece of paper, that is also up to you. No issues. So this is a template. It's a 5x5 grid is what we are going to use. So I think all of you can just maybe, you know, since we are talking about four categories, just have four sheets with this grid drawn on it ready for you so that you can start working on it. So the first starting point we will work with is once upon a time. Now, once upon a time, like I mentioned, this is how to think, this is one way we can use to think of an idea, which is starting with a story. So as a brief, let's take the very popular, very classic and very simple story of the race between rabbit and tortoise, based on the moral, you know, slow and steady wins the race. So let's take this as an example. I would like all of you to, you know, take this. Yes, but before that, I'll show, discuss about how we can start thinking. So in any story, again, we will take this race of the rabbit and the tortoise as a topic, as a brief. So when you think about that story, I'm sure everyone, I hope all of you know about that story. If not, I'll just quickly tell you, there was a race. The rabbit was very, you know, he felt that he's very fast, he will win anyways. So they start racing, and the rabbit, almost before reaching the end, he thinks ki are mere ko kaun harayega, so he slept. And then the tortoise, he kept on constantly at his pace, and the rabbit just slept off, and the tortoise finished the race and won. So it has a moral that, you know, when you do things slowly, it's not an issue, but if you do it steadily and with patience and with consistency, you can achieve great things. But at the same time, it doesn't mean that if you do things fast, it's a bad thing. It's just that you should not get over your head and think, you know, I'm better because I have so many skills. So yeah, that is the story in short. I'm sure all of you know it. So yeah, so when you think about that story, it gives you characters. You have a tortoise and a hare. So automatically, you know, you can make, okay, there's a possibility of making a two-player game. The goal, the story itself tells you whoever finishes the race first. So you get a goal from that story, the mechanic. Now, certain aspects when you're planning will require your creativity of thinking what new you can think of. So the mechanic, obviously here the mechanic is a race to finish because that is how it is in the story. So how can you create a mechanic in a board game? It's something very simple and very obvious is you throw a dice. Aapko one aata, you move one. The other person throws a dice, unko one ya three aata, they move three. This keeps on happening, and so that is a mechanic, a race to finish. So you have a mechanic for your game. The rules. Now rules would be, again, like, you know, you throw a dice, the every player goes turn by turn, those can be the rules. Again, the goal will also become part of the rule, which is whoever finishes first. Now, so rules will basically be a more elaborate description of the mechanic. Mechanic tells you what is going to happen, and the rules are going to specifically tell you if you have any more changes. Now the theme, the story is automatically about tortoise and hare, so that becomes the theme. You know, if you suppose you work on this game and you make a layout, so you know, you can show maybe a jungle, and then you can show the pawns that you make for the game can be like a rabbit and a tortoise. Your board could actually look like a map of a, like a top view of a jungle map. So that basically gives you an idea about the theme, the visual layout and the visual elements of the board game. The next is challenges. Now, like I mentioned, challenges is what will make the game interesting. Now for this story, what can you take from the story to make challenges? One is, since in the story, the rabbit is always faster than the tortoise, then is it possible that in the game you give one player an advantage of moving faster and the other player the disadvantage of moving slowly? But in the story, it also says that the rabbit had a habit of, you know, thinking ki ya main to better hoon. So the rabbit would sleep in the story. So maybe you can also give a challenge to the person who moves very fast, is that at certain points in the game, if they land there, they will go to sleep and they will miss out on a turn. And maybe for that, the tortoise can take the advantage of moving ahead. So I'm just giving you hints. So these are things that you can use. So as you can see from the story itself, you can get characters, goal, the mechanic, you know, set of rules, a theme and challenges. So So for this first session, I will share with you an idea that I had made based on this discussion, so that you get a feel of how you can use these elements and turn them into like an idea for a board game. So this will be so this is just an example. After this, I will be giving you time to think your own ideas also, or you could actually use this idea and work on it also. This is not an issue. It's just to get you into this thing of making, coming up with an idea. So I thought of a name, ki slow and steady may not win the race, because in the game, because the story says ki tortoise finish karta hai, but game mein toh we'll have to give equal opportunity to all the players to win. So the theme is of course the tortoise and the hare race against each other to the finish line. For the mechanic, what I thought was, So whenever the tortoise moves, suppose the tortoise moves one step, the rabbit gets to move 1+1, two steps. So if the tortoise moves two steps, the rabbit gets to move 2+1, three steps. So at that I am taking inspiration from the story itself, because the rabbit is always faster than the tortoise. Now for the rules, I have mentioned there ki the tortoise starts, that is the first player, and can move only one or two squares in this grid. Now how do you decide when one and when two? So if we have a dice, suppose whenever the dice throws an odd number like 1, 3, 5 or 7 to any 1, 3, 5, the tortoise gets to move one, and whenever the tortoise throws even, the tortoise gets to move two. And suppose if I am the tortoise, so I throw a dice and I move one step, the next time the person who's playing the rabbit does not have to throw a dice, they just have to move +1. So they are automatically moving ahead. But if you see on the board on the right side, I have drawn some colored some squares. I have mentioned 1, 2, 3. So there, when I was talking about challenge, you have to put a challenge or a conflict to make the game interesting. There I mentioned if by chance the rabbit lands on any one of these squares, then the rabbit will go to sleep and will miss out on the number that is mentioned on the square. The rabbit will miss out on those many turns. So suppose if the rabbit lands on the first square, which says 1, then the tortoise will get to move a step without the rabbit moving, and then the rabbit will again wake up and then again start moving. Similarly, if the rabbit ends up landing on 3, then the rabbit will miss out on 3 steps. So it will be like sleeping for 3 steps, and the tortoise can in the meanwhile keep on moving and trying to finish the race. So this is basically the rules. Yeah, one more thing, because in a game, the other thing that you have to keep in mind is you have to give equal opportunity to both. Aisa nahi hona chahiye ki, you know, the rabbit feels ki, I am at a disadvantage. I don't have any choice. Whatever the tortoise does, accordingly I move. If I land on this, then I have to, you know, I'll have to sleep, I'll lose my steps and all. So the advantage might fall onto the side of the tortoise. So I have given another advantage, or like another power to say, to the rabbit, is that only once in the game the rabbit will get the option to move one extra step. So let's say the tortoise moved one step and the rabbit was going to land on the second square, the 2 wala square, but at that time the rabbit has an option, okay, I will move one more so that I get saved from sleeping and I can move, continue with the race. But wo pure game mein ek hi bar milega karne ke liye. Because again, we are sticking to the story, because it's to show how the rabbit had a chance that he could have not slept at that time. So ek chance to banta hai kisi. And the goal, so the challenge is that you have to plan your steps in advance. Hence, there's a small amount of strategy, because if I am the tortoise, I know, oh, if I move 2, the rabbit will move 3, and I can make sure that the rabbit lands on a square where the rabbit will go to sleep. So I can strategize like that. But since we have a dice in this game, so a luck element bhi aa jata hai, because now the tortoise doesn't know ki wo 1 chalega ya 2 chalega. So it can work both ways. Of course, the goal is whoever ends the race first wins. So this is just to give you an idea of how I took the story of the rabbit and the tortoise, and I basically dissected the story and looked at the elements, and I came up with mechanics, rules, a challenge in the game, which is like obstacles, and of course a goal. कि हाउ द बो हाउ द गेम विल फिनिश एंड हु विल हाउ डू वी मेक श्योर हु विंस. So now what we will do is, again, right now, if anyone has any questions, I would be willing to take it up.
Yeah, just asking for the questions. Just okay. A minute.
So while people are thinking of the questions, what we'll do next is I will give you a gap where you have to use the same grid, 5x5 grid, and think of an idea in a similar manner. And then maybe we can take a couple of them and discuss.
Yeah.
What I've made here also, I'm not saying it is foolproof because I have not tested it. So I was just trying to see that can I also on the spot think of an idea. So if I can, I'm sure all of you.
That's
can.
A great idea, actually. I would also like to try one.
The smaller template can also, you could also try to play it on your own. Just keep two pieces and try it out and how it, you know, goes about.
Right. So I think in this session, we don't have a question as such. So let's see. We'll try to, like, they will try to make it, and I think they'll get questions as they're trying, maybe.
As they're trying to make.
Yeah, as they're trying to make. So we'll go about. So let's give them a time.
So the next is, let's take, right now it is 3:25, 3:26. Let's take 15 minutes. And after 15 minutes, I think Sharmishta can also just clarify whatever you are making. Either you can click a photo. Just make sure it's just a single page or a single slide of a PPT or a digital thing. And you can share it on the drive, and then we can have a 5-minute discussion after that.
Of course, of course. So let's just see. I think they've given. Yeah, it's a, so we'll put a break now. We'll start a break now, and then they will, as I get questions, then after the break, I'll discuss those questions with you.
Cool. I will still be online if in between.
Of course, we are online. Yes, yes.
But for 15 minutes, you can think of ideas. I think that will help you start thinking.
Right. Yes, so there was just one question that just came up. Okay. It's about the rules. Like whenever they're making rules, so in the first stage, like how will they kind of know if they're going in the right direction or not? Is it like if they're not interacting with someone? So is there a method or is there a process how they can go about it?
Yeah. So like I said, in my case, because I've been doing it for like so many years, I can probably mentally play my mind, you know, this will what will happen. I can take a guess, like an informed assumption. But to be honest, the only way to do this is you make a rule and try it out.
Okay.
At least play it for like the first maybe 10 steps. And in that, it makes sense, then probably you're on the right track. But if within the first 10 steps, you feel, you know, there is some confusion or maybe this is not interesting, or maybe you can try out those challenges that you're thinking of in the initial section itself to know how is the experience. Like I told you, even the idea that I made, I haven't tested it. So it might be, there might be some flaws in it, but the only way to improve on it is play. So I just know I think the challenges for the rabbit should be spaced out. They should not be in one place. Taki, you know, har stage mein lage ki, I can trap the rabbit here, or the tortoise can think I can trap the rabbit in the next stage, or even in the end. And as if I trap the rabbit in the last stage, I can get the rabbit to sleep for more steps. So then start strategizing. So
of course. So right now you are thinking on a very small scale, like it was just a 5x5 square. But when it becomes a little bigger, I think the rules will also kind of have to become that much wider. Like you will have to test it. So there must be they might have to do a survey or something like that, or play with their.
Best is to play with someone.
Yeah,
themselves, or usually best is to play with someone else.
Of course, right.
It's really boring when you play it with yourself.
Okay, so Austin, right now what is happening is students are asking question, but I think they're not able to submit like the drive or something.
Which is fine. I think maybe even subsequently, if it happens, it's fine. Maybe after the workshop, if someone wants to.
Right, like submit the work. Yeah, that sounds fine. So maybe I'll go with whatever questions people are asking, we can discuss, and then we can go ahead with the next session. I think they're not yet in the mode of like maybe making it or not understanding. So once you are done with the presentation, they might be able to get the idea clearly, the process
So I'll keep on giving this 10-minute break, in which if they want to, I think once they start making, they will also get questions. They might not be able to make an idea,
but they
start getting questions, so which is also fine.
Yeah, so questions, yeah. I think that will work. We are getting questions, so... But mostly, yeah, it has to do with, yeah, they're like the theme and all. They were thinking about, like, when we are thinking of the theme. So generally, all the themes that we've seen in the board games that are by now. So one is like you said, like the Monopoly has to do with business. I think that's what the question states. So it has to do, like, it's with the business. And then when some are generally for us is the stories that we have been hearing. So like you said, that it's mostly neighborhood, like look towards your side or something like that interest. But is there a, like some people are like, not how to start, like how to start with getting, that is, I think the question that they're starting, like
start getting,
how to get the theme, like how to get on with the theme.
So since in this idea, in this specific idea, you're starting with a theme. The theme can be anything. I gave you tortoise and hair. Maybe, suppose you love the Avengers movie. Maybe you would like to make a game on Avengers, but you try to understand every, like if you remember in the, like when I was a kid, of course I'm quite old now, we used to play with these WWF wrestlers cards, and yeah, there they had their, what you said, the number of fights won, their height, their weight and all these things. So they used those elements and turned it into a card game. So similarly, okay, I think there is no restriction on what theme you should take. I think you should take up whatever interests you. But of course, it requires a lot of practice. Like I said, now this is where the creativity part comes in. That how are you able to adapt that story, understand its elements, and put it on a board game?
Right. Of course, what I just thought, maybe like how we have the process of, like students are saying, like mind mapping, they're just interacting within themselves, like saying mind mapping, brainstorming and those kind of the process that they know of. So one thing that I just thought is maybe the theme in general might not work. Like there is sometimes like you have this idea with you and then it just does not work, and then students might get like disheartened that, oh, this is not working, because right now we're just making it into board games. But can it go wider? Like what can board game, in board games also, could it be a wider range of board games, not just dice or something? Is there something else that is like?
So board games, I think a lot of, I think the popular understanding is you have a board, you have pawns. You
yeah.
But you know, something like Jenga is also a tabletop game. I won't call it a board game, it's a tabletop game.
Yeah.
Similarly, there are tabletop games where there is no fixed board, but you get tiles and you just have to attach them and make a board, and then you get points about it.
That's interesting.
Again, the word board games actually restricts it, but it's about tangible tabletop games. And there are a lot of card-based games, but we don't play it like our playing cards. But there are games which have cards, and then I think
the rule cards kind of,
and you have like instructions and rules of what to do. It might not have a board, but where you place it itself becomes a game.
Right. So
there is a lot of scope, and but again, I think the more you play, the more you experiment. Sometimes a person who has not played any game before might come up with a very drastically different idea, because you get influenced by the things that you play with you. But sometimes playing a lot of games can also give you an idea, okay, this has been done, maybe we can go a step beyond.
Yes. So I think that's it. Like that is what the discussion is going on, but I haven't yet seen like anybody submitting any work per se for now. And so yeah, like you said, maybe we can do the submission part, like maybe after the workshop or something when the...
Which is fine. So, but I'll still continue giving.
Yeah, words. Of course. That is a good idea actually, because like you said, they do have questions. So maybe when you give the next step, and they will have more questions, even if they do not submit, they do have questions coming up. They're doing discussions amongst themselves. So I think that's good. Like, I think that break is a good thing where they are at least trying to understand the process. So yeah, let's
I think since the topic is quite wide and I wanted to touch upon all four of them, it's okay even if they just take up one idea at the end and just have one game to discuss, because every game finally you have to end up thinking of all aspects. As I mean, every direction has a different, it gives a different game.
Yes.
It's just, I'm just discussing about the starting points. Ultimately, all the factors remain the same for any board game.
Right. Okay,
so I think we can then move on to the next.
Yes, I think yes. We should move on and then it will just keep coming and I'll break in between and tell you the questions. Like.
Yeah, so the first one was that you can maybe take up a story and start with that. Another starting point could be a core mechanic where it's not necessary that you have a story in mind, but you have a mechanic. Like maybe I want to make a like a memory based game. Maybe they might have played a game where you keep all the cards upside down and then you have to find the pair. So that's a mechanic. That's a mechanic of how you play. And then you might want to take that mechanic and turn it into a game. So for this session, I will give you, like I said, there are hundreds of mechanics which have been documented, and I think that is something if someone is really interested in working in the area of board games, they can, I think, have a look at all the various types of mechanics that are there. So I'll take one mechanic, which is, it can have multiple names. So I'm just saying capture territory. So in the grid, now let us look at, so in the first idea, we looked at the grid as a map with a path. Now we are going to look at the same grid as a area, an empty area, and you have to capture the maximum area. I don't know whether you have played, like in school we used to make a grid with dots and then we would keep on drawing one line. Pehle main draw karunga, fir someone else will draw, then I will draw, then someone else will draw. And if you are able to make complete one square, it becomes yours. And at the end you count who made maximum number of squares. So basically that is also somewhere on the similar concept where on a grid, you try to cover maximum area. So let's take that mechanic as a brief for the next one. So the one who will own most square blocks in that grid wins. Now, suppose let's take this mechanic as an idea, then how would you think about it? Again, coming back. So these elements will always be the same for any board game. Now let's take an example ki hum le rahe hain capturing territory or capturing an area. So like someone was asking, no, kaise hum theme ke bare mein sochte hain. So if the mechanic is about capturing territory, maybe I could make the theme as two countries fighting for territory, or maybe two kingdoms at war trying to gain territory, or maybe it is or maybe it is there are two nations who have sent out their spies and they are trying to expand their network. So main apna network increase karu, I've put a spy here, spy. Ultimately hum dekhenge kiske zyada spies hai, to wo that person wins. So the theme in this case, so in the previous example, the story was the anchor point and that led you to all the other aspects of the board game. In this case, the mechanic will be the anchor point, and that will, from there you can think of what theme and what goals and what challenges you can keep. So theme can be accordingly decided based on the mechanic, like capturing territory. So we are taking that as an example. Of course, the mechanic itself dictates what the goal will be, which is whoever captures the maximum area wins. So it's quite straightforward. Mechanic, it's already defined because you're starting with a core mechanic. Rules again, depending upon the kind of game that you think of. So let's say if we go back to that old example that I was giving in school, we used to play, we used to join the dots and whoever makes the square gets, just say if both of us are playing, so I will write A if I am able to complete a square, and if someone else is playing, like if Sharmisha is playing, she will write S in her box. So we will line draw karte rahenge, and at the end whoever makes the maximum number of squares. So the rule will be, I will draw a line, she will draw a line, then I will draw a line, then she will draw a line. Aisa karke. So that is the rule. And the goal is, of course, whoever creates maximum squares. So wo rules, again, rules will, they don't pop up as soon as you think of an idea. The more you expand on the idea, detail it out, the more clarity you will get on what should be the rules of the game. And mostly in any game, the rules, mostly the first aspect of a rule is that how do you start the game? Who plays first? How do you move? what card are you supposed to select. So it basically gives a direction about how to use the product. Because like if you keep board games aside, you any product that you buy, agar aap, you know, any utensil or anything, uske sath ek manual aata hai. The manual basically tells you how to use it. The rule books are also something similar, because the board game is also a product and it tells you basically how to use it. And just like kabhi kabhi when you buy an electrical device, to uske sath jo book aata hai, it is so complicated. Like if you buy a new laptop or a new phone, उसमें इतने सारे आते हैं, चार्जिंग ऐसे करना है, ये ऐसे करना है, वो ऐसे करना है. सो इवन दे मेक श्योर दैट द लैंग्वेज इज वेरी सिंपल एंड टू द पॉइंट. जस्ट लाइक दैट आई थिंक दैट गोज फॉर ऑल प्रोडक्ट्स एंड स्पेसिफिकली फॉर बोर्ड गेम्स इट हैज टू बी वेरी क्रिस्प एंड वेरी स्पेसिफिक, बिकॉज दैट एक्चुअली रियली डिफाइन्स हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू यूज इट. बिकॉज एवरी बोर्ड गेम इज न्यू, एवरी बोर्ड गेम इज डिफरेंट. बट इन अदर प्रोडक्ट्स यू माइट बी बाइंग द सेम प्रोडक्ट ऑफ अनदर ब्रांड, सो यू ऑलरेडी नो हाउ टू हैंडल इट. बट बोर्ड गेम्स में ऐसा नहीं होता. Theme again, like I said, this is the mechanic, it's about capturing area. So aap socho, which is the best story that connects with capturing area. You know, it could also be two different species, like earthlings versus some aliens. They are coming and they have to take over this planet. Whoever captures maximum territory will own the planet. So somewhere like a feeling of competition comes in. That can help you in thinking of a theme. So again, depending upon your interest, your creativity, and what are the stories that you are exposed to, you can think of your own theme. Challenges will again depend upon how you are using this mechanic. So maybe one challenge, isme challenge shayad ye ho sakta hai ki if you are able to make 4 squares nearby, then it becomes a bigger square, and that bigger square gives you more marks. So the challenge becomes ki how do I create a bigger square. Of course, aise karke there can be so many ideas, but like I said, matlab that totally depends upon the creative side and your ability to understand ki okay, what are the different ways in which I can do. So I am able to think of these things because of the fact that I have worked with board games and I have also played a lot of board games. So this is how again you start with a mechanic, you think of a theme for that mechanic is covering how can you cover maximum area, taking that grid as a like an inspiration, keeping that fixed. So we will do the same thing again. I will again give you, let's take 10-15 minutes, and during that again you can think of an idea or questions, whichever it is.
Austin, though, there is one question that has come up for the last one, the last ideation. So as the rabbit has a physical advantage and the story is all positive that tortoise can't lay any traps, should we stick to that ideology or should we try something new?
Is not necessary. Not necessary. Yeah. There is no compulsion. No one is stopping you. Koi dekh nahi raha hai. Tumne ye story ko manipulate kiya. Actually, when I said ki does slow and being slow and steady really help you win the race, I was just taking a comical stand on the moral of the story. So it's just giving a funny angle. So aisa koi compulsion nahi hota ki if you have taken a story, you have to stick to it. Unless you are working as a designer and you have been given a project ki aapko ek ek cheez isme match karni hai, then it becomes another challenge. But if you're just thinking of an idea, there is no harm. You can take any story, you can manipulate it in any way. It is just for inspiration, for you to think of a idea.
Just a starting point.
You could take inspiration from the tortoise and hare and later on change the story altogether only. You might have a lion and a mouse. So it doesn't matter, because ultimately the person who's playing it, they need to get a good experience of play.
There could also be more than two characters later on.
There could be more than two characters.
Yeah. So one more question, like they were asking, like how about merging two board games? Like, is there been an effort done to be merging like two different types of board games? Have you ever?
I am sure a lot of people have played it, but I can't think of something which is like a commercial product very popular which has done that. But a lot of many times when we are thinking of like new board game ideas. Or for that matter of fact, in any creative activity, it's a very popular approach where you combine two things, merge them to come up with a new idea. So that can also be done. For example, let's say you want to combine like Jenga with like a race. ठीक है. So every time you take out a block, उसमें एक number लिखा होगा and you move your तो आपको अच्छे से निकालना है. If it falls down, maybe some penalty gets added. So you can always club two things and मैंने Jenga वो अलग अलग रखा है, but you could merge them into some new product. Maybe when you remove a block, you can place your animal over there. You remove another block, the animal goes there. You remove upper wala block, animal goes over there. So who can win the race?
Yeah.
So it is possible basically. Not two, three, four, jitna bhi aapko depending upon your ability.
Yeah. Now, as I've also seen like people making the board game more interactive and physical, like putting some kind of challenges in there. Those kind of things are also been done now, like to make it little more.
One example is, again, when I just mentioned Jenga, there is a version of Jenga which is a truth and dare version of Jenga.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. That's so what I thought of.
Question kuch de rakha hoga, which you have to perform or give the
truth. Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
People do club things together.
Yeah. And so now we have one more question. So in the world of PS4, how can we make the board games trendy?
In the world of that is
quite very different genre.
Because people who play PS4, they are looking for a certain type of experience.
Yeah.
And the experience of playing a physical board game with people around you, that is very different.
Absolutely.
But again, depends upon your
imagination.
Ability and your imagination. Maybe since we see board game as a static thing, like if in a digital game, imagine if you are like, I am remembering that scene from Harry Potter where Harry Potter was on a chessboard, like a big, huge chessboard.
Oh, right. Yes. He was
with the pawns moving. So if you can create that sort of an experience of a board game inside a digital, what, forget digital, in a virtual reality game, to aur kya, matlab that could be something different.
Absolutely. Something we are like now, people are trying out to make them more like a real kind of experience, something like that. Already, I've seen a few, I think they have started making those kind of.
Yeah. People are already working on it. I've seen games which were 2D, like Plants vs. Zombies. It's a smartphone game. But there is a 3D version of it, where you will actually, the characters are moving around and then they are attacking each other. So like board games are 2D, even phones have 2D games, which are like a top view. But then they give characters life, give them animation, make an actual 3D world around it. Like if you look at Mario has been like a popular 2D game. Side scroll, but now there are so many 3D versions of Mario.
One is saying, I'm not sure if this came a little earlier. The game Othello works on this mechanics, right? I have no idea about the game Othello, so I'm not sure if.
I think they, if they are looking at the visual, maybe they are thinking.
Okay.
Or if that person is asking whether Othello works on the concept of capture territory, then yes, that is also a version of capture territory where you turn the piece and if you have more black, you have captured more territory. So that's a very good example of that mechanic being adapted there.
Yeah.
It is also a square grid, a bigger grid.
Yeah. Okay, nice. Okay, I think those are the questions. I think we covered the questions for now. But I think there's a glitch, like we're not getting any. So I think we could move on from, and people are still working. That is what I can see.
I think if there are people who are working on ideas, then they drop a message that they are working. Maybe we can add 5 more minutes. Otherwise, we can move on to the next section.
Okay, we have put the question. Let's see if somebody does put the work and then we can, but I don't know if they are shy or something, I'm not sure, but nobody is putting up anything. So I think we can just go on, and like you said, we'll by the end.
Working,
they're working. So people are working.
What I think, I would definitely have to say this, that it is not easy, you know, 15 minutes to sochna. I think you need like an entire day or maybe a week to really think and come up with new ideas.
Right. But
I just thought that, you know, sometimes, you know, whatever comes to your mind, try karke dekho, just to get an idea. So right. The objective, I think this is for everyone, that the objective of this session is not to be able to make a complete game, but just to be able to open up your brain. Okay, this is also how we can think of an idea. Otherwise, 1.5 hours is not enough for...
Of course. It's just getting started. Like,
just a morning session for you to start your journey on making board games, probably.
I would like to say this. Don't think about the visuals and all, guys. Just think about the strategy and how you can get working on just understanding the board games as a concept. And whatever, if you guys have, then I think we can continue with the next one. And by the end of the time, when we have time, maybe by then they can submit some work.
Yeah. So what I did was, like in the first one, I gave an example before I gave you the time to think of an idea. But in the subsequent ones, I have given you time first and then I will show you my example. Okay. So I also did this exercise with myself. I also, within like whatever time I had today, I was trying to see if I can think of some new idea in that time.
So they're saying they're almost there. I hope they will send it soon.
Okay, fine. So again, the starting point being mechanic, and I had suggested that capturing territory mechanic. So I was trying to think of this game again. Theme ke baare mein main immediately tab soch nahi paya. Of course, the things were coming in my mind. It could be kingdoms attacking, or it could be, you know, aliens versus humans, or I don't know, something of that sort, some topic. The mechanic was how I adopted the mechanic to turn it into a game is, so this is the board. Like I said, we have to use the board in all the exercises that we do. So keeping this grid in mind, there will be, so I'll just read it from what I had written. Use the shapes given to place on the board matching to the intersection points and capture maximum area. So if you see on the top of the board, if you can see my cursor, there are these blocks, like the blue and the orange ones, like a big rectangle, a square and a triangle. So turn by turn, depending upon the number of players, there could be, if there are four, there could be four colors. If there are two, there could be two colors. So you place one block, then the next player places their block, then I will place my block, then they. So like that, we keep on placing the blocks. So in rules, what I mentioned was every shape should be placed aligned with the grid. So you can't place it randomly anywhere on this. Line ke upar laga diya ya teda karke laga diya. It has to be aligned with the grid. So that is why you have to, it has to be very specific when you are explaining the rules. I was imagining that there will be like a box with lot of these pieces, rectangle, square and triangle, mix hoga. There will be, so you can't really select which one you are taking, but you take something without, randomly you pick up a piece and then you place it. Because once you pick up, then you decide, okay, where should I keep it? Should I keep it at the edge? Should I keep it next to my opponent's piece? Or should I expand my area? So depending upon how they want to strategize. So the challenge, to add a challenge here, what I've done is every piece will have a value in terms of the size. So the biggest piece is of value 3, the smaller one of 2 and the smallest one of 1. So at the end, after you have done placing all the pieces, we can calculate ki kiska kya score ho gaya. Again, now, after I had, and the goal would be whenever, whoever scores the maximum wins the game. But after I made this game, so I gave myself like 10-15 minutes. Uske baad mereko aur ideas aa rahe the. Ki, you know, like when I was trying out, so this is what I was doing. I was playing with myself. Maine jo yahan pe example diya, I put one digitally kar raha tha. I was doing it on PPT itself. I took one block, placed it there. Uska copy karke side mein dala. Usko copy karke side mein dala. So I was playing against my own self. So there I realized ki, suppose someone is able to make like a bigger continuous block, they might get extra points. there could be some blocks on the grid where there can be some, just a Scrabble mein, if you make a game on a certain block, you get double the points. So again, like someone was asking, can we club to game idea? So it is very much possible. You can take inspiration from there and put it here. Like in the hare and tortoise, I had put ki if you land on a block, you lose a chance. Probably you might get one piece, which will read ki because you picked up this piece, you don't get a chance to play. And that piece is given to the opponent. So aise karke there can be surprise events also. So this is again, actually how to think of these ideas, there is no rule. I think this is, you just have to let your imagination loose and, you know, think of the craziest ideas, try it out and then make it practical. So this was an idea that I came up with after I made this as a brief for myself. So this is to just to show you how I, you know, went about, you know, starting with an idea. It's not necessary that, you know, this will remain the same. The more I work on it, the more it will change. For example, the shapes don't have to be geometric. It could be on a square grid. It could be circular shapes, curved shapes, which fit within each other, you know, exactly and properly. So there could be, again, it's all up to your ability to think of multiple ideas. So yeah, so this was the idea, just to show how you can take up a mechanic and from that mechanic, take inspiration to think of an idea. Doesn't have to be a story. Yeah. So the next, another way to start thinking of an idea is to test a skill. Like I said, skills are of many types: physical, strategic, logical, puzzle solving, or it could just be, you might not want to test a skill at all. You just want to be like play a game, which is purely based on luck, like snakes and ladders. Or when Ludo is interesting, it has a mix of strategy and luck. Luck because you're dependent upon a dice, and strategy because you get to choose ki main apna pawn ghar se bahar nikalu, or should I attack someone else, or should I finish, make sure this pawn is able to reach the home first. So there is some level of strategy that you do. And sometimes in that game, you also make teams with the opponent ki yaar hum dono team kar lete hain aur isko hara dete hain, and then both of us will play against each other. So all these are not written in the rules, but these happen when the game becomes more interesting. So yeah, so testing a skill that could also help you in thinking of an idea. For example, agar aap Jenga loge, to Jenga, there is no mechanic in Jenga. Jenga is a tabletop game. It's not a board game. It's a tabletop game, physical tabletop game. So somewhere they must have thought ki we want to test the balancing skills, or how sensitively they can use their grip to remove, you know, make sure that the structure doesn't fall or break. Or they might have seen how people stack things and, you know, construct things. So wahan se maybe they might got an inspiration to make a game like this. So somewhere testing a skill can also be a point which you can use to think of a new idea. So for this, again, we will keep the layout of the grid, 5x5 grid. And the brief is that you're testing the puzzle solving skills of a person. So puzzles could be of any type. It could be a visual, because this is a visual layout right now. So we will work with visual puzzles and working with speed. So those are two skills that you can use to think of a new idea. Because every board game has similar attributes. If you're taking the topic of skill, we want to make a game that tests the puzzle solving skills and speed. So characters to depends. Matlab, suppose you want to give a theme to this game, it could be Sherlock Holmes versus some Einstein, or scientists at war. You know, that could be a theme. The characters are like scientists and they have to mix things and solve some puzzle. I don't know. Or it could be two brilliant mathematicians trying to, you know, crack a code or something. So again, like in the previous case, from the mechanic of capturing territory, I was thinking of ideas connected to it. Now here, since puzzles is about thinking and being, you know, intelligent. So what are the themes that you can think of that connects with intelligence? Or it could also be, like on a funnier note, it could be a war between two very dumb people trying to solve codes. So because, you know, that's the beauty of play and games. There is no restriction. Aapko jo theme sochna hai, you can, you know, apply it over there. Whichever you feel will become more fun and more interesting. since it's puzzle, maybe the goal could be कौन पहले puzzle solve करता है, or it could be in who can solve the puzzle in less number of attempts, or the goal could be who is able to solve a more complex puzzle. So similarly, depending, there can be different types of goals. Mechanic, here the mechanic would be again depending upon the kind of puzzle you are trying to solve. Suppose the puzzle is you are given like couple of tiles, it is an image, and aapko wo sahi orientation mein laga ke you have to find out what the image is, jo wo aate hai na, you have to complete the puzzle piece. So similarly, something like this can also be a mechanic, and there can be a time ki aap, whoever finishes the puzzle first finishes it. So the mechanic is taking a visual piece and connecting them to complete the picture. Rules again depend upon once you ideate the game and you know what you're trying to make. Theme, like I said, it could be two people or number of people testing out their intelligence. So, usse connected jo bhi theme aap soch sakte, you can apply to a game. But like I said in the beginning, it is not necessary the game has to have a theme. Like a game of cross and knots, it does not have any theme. It is just logical. You draw crosses and knots, and you're trying to create a line. And challenges isme automatically time will become a challenge, kaun pehle karta hai, and the level of puzzle complication will become a challenge, that like how in digital games also your level of difficulty keeps on increasing, even in a board game maybe the challenges can keep on increasing, the level of complexity of the puzzle. So I will give you like 10 to 15 minutes, and maybe you can just think, if you can think of some ideas. In fact, if you don't have to draw it on paper also, if you just type out an idea, maybe we just have a quick discussion on that too, like just like a one liner.
Yeah, that could be a good idea. Maybe they have some ideas, but they're not able to make it visually.
Yeah, uploading it on the drive and making it digitally, that might be taking
time. Yeah. Yeah, that's a good idea, actually.
If anyone wants to discuss any idea,
yeah,
like break for 10 minutes and
okay, sure. We'll give them 5-10 minutes. I'll be sharing the screen with you. Someone has sent us something, so let's check out. But I'll just get Monish, right? Yes.
Monish.
I'll start sharing this.
Oh, I'll have to start sharing then, I think, first.
Yeah, please. Thank you. So I think there's one document. Hmm. Do you want me to read it out?
I'll read it out.
Yeah, thank you.
It is a game of four players. Each player has one family, which is consists of brother, sister, mom and dad, where everyone has to move in the given path. The whole family has to reach the lottery endpoint to make their life better. But the place where there is interaction, there the player can send that particular character to home again. Players have to roll their dice, which has 5 probability. It represents the ups and downs in middle class family. Yeah, I think this is a perfect starting point. So from what I understand, a family is moving to a point where they can improve their lives, and in the path, they can feel, you know, get obstacles, which is luck based. So now, so it made a description also. These are the characters, and
I like the idea of using shapes as the characters. Very simple. Nice. It could be more thought on.
So I think the direction in which the players move, I think if there is more description about how that happens, it might be more clear. Or I think that's an example of how they can.
Yeah,
I think they have to come to the center ultimately. I think that is what probably it shows, I guess. But yeah, so I think if the path is along, instead of moving in blocks, see how the grid has been used in a different way. Instead of moving along the blocks, you can actually move on those lines and keep on coming to a certain point and go back and forth. So like I was telling you, in games, you should always try to have a balance. So aisa bhi nahi lagna chahiye ki yaar baar baar peeche ja rahe hain, but na aage jaane ke liye we should have some more powers or something of that sort. Again, when you play this game, now this is completely luck based because dice pe depend karta hai, but you could also give some sort of powers that maybe if you like I said in the earlier one, in the hair wala ki the rabbit has the option to choose its power of moving another step at any stage in the game. Similarly here, I think they could also have maybe if they land on a certain space, they get a card which is like ki this maybe the kid grows up and the kid gets a job, so now they have more better financial strength, so now next time if they get a negative number, they can actually cancel it and keep on moving ahead, because that also reflects upon how life in life, how a family keeps on growing even in the midst of obstacles. They are able to get jobs and get more money or have houses or have, you know, support from friends and family. There could be a card of friends and family. Whenever they are in trouble, maybe they can take a friend card. The friend card might say, okay, you can skip this issue. So something like that. You can keep on expanding on it.
Yeah. Okay, I'll just stop sharing the screen.
Yeah.
Also, there is one question, one idea that has been sent. We can have a game based on two tigers where they have to obtain most territory by solving math.
Okay.
The grid will have a question and need a moderator where the two players will have to solve, and whoever solve first will keep the color for like that.
From what I understand, how I'm visualizing it is that there is a grid. Maybe on every block there is a question, a math question, and if you give the answer, you can keep your, if it's correct, uska answer niche likha hoga. Agar wo correct hai, then you can keep your color.
Yeah.
So the theme of having tigers as players playing math, it's funny, but I was thinking the other way, that maybe there are two people stuck in a jungle, and the only way they can save themselves is by finding like ways to go out. So aap ek sahi answer doge to maybe you will get a torch which will be of your help. And if you give a wrong answer, you might land up in front of a cave and then you know maybe some someone might attack you or maybe you lose your phone or aapka network chale jata hai. So yeah, but overall I think the mechanic of capturing territory gives you ideas ki theek hai, I have to capture maximum territory because the terminology of the mechanics has territory, so automatically dimag mein aata hai territory, but it can be very different. Like in this idea, I think it's got nothing to do with territory, but yes, the more boxes you open, the more chances are that you will win. But I think that is also an interesting application of learning in board games. Yeah. So Sharmisha, I think I'll just quickly move on to the last section because the time
is. Yeah, please do. Yes.
Yeah. But yeah, I think both those ideas were very interesting. Good points to start off with, and they are also not like तो बहुत सुना ऐसा भी नहीं. I think they're very new.
Interesting and new. Yes.
Yeah, very interesting. So yeah, so I'll just quickly tell you the example that came to my mind when I was thinking. So we were discussing about puzzles. So I thought, imagine that. So I won't read. I'll just quickly explain. You just have a look at the visual. Imagine that the grid is made up of different sticks. You know, every line is a equal size of sticks. पूरा ऐसे grid में arrange कर दिया. And the puzzle is maybe ऐसा एक image आपको मिलता है when you pick up a card. And now you have to quickly remove sticks and make sure only this image is left. So it has like your ability to visualize कि हाँ इतने इतने sticks निकाले. इसमें तो I have mapped it on the grid, so it is very easy to see. But in the card, it might be of a smaller size, so you don't know ki whether it is 2 or 1. But you have to figure out how you can make this image by removing sticks. The challenge here will be that if you pick up one stick, you can't place it back. So suppose if you make a mistake at the beginning, then you're gone. Then if the other person will automatically win. So this was an idea that started off with testing a skill. Ki haan, ye puzzle hai, visual puzzle hai, isko solve karna hai, and you have to do it with speed. So whoever does it first wins. Again, because it was a short time, I was not able to think of a theme. But I don't know the theme could be since I used the word untangle, maybe the theme could be to do with ropes and images. Maybe the image might be like the image of a tiger. If you are able to create the tiger, then you get one animal. If someone else creates a ball, they get a ball. I said maybe something can be played out on that, on those lines. So the last starting point I want to discuss today is adopt and adapt. So this is a bit more something connecting with what we do at our department, is trying to study what is happening around us and taking inspiration from there to come up with a board game for that situation. So usually we work with design intervention and solving concerns and people's issues, or maybe you know, like there was an idea which can use maths and learning. So we work in a lot of projects that deal with education and classroom teaching and learning, or training people, or it could be to improve people's mental health, or to help people pass time or learn something new. So there are a lot of applications that we look at. So here, let's take an example of memorizing. Now, memorizing is taking inspiration from how whenever we are traveling, हम गाड़ी में जाते तो हम try to remember क्या है, left लेना था, फिर right लेना था, फिर आगे जाके दो turn के बाद right लेना, and then we will reach our destination. And if we are not able to remember it, you might take a wrong turn, and then you will take more time to reach that area. So that is a real life experience that most of us go through. So let's take that as a brief and try to think of how we can take this idea to turn it into a board game idea. Again, coming back to the same factors, the reason why I am showing you this slide again and again is to make you understand that at the end, irrespective of the approach you take, the elements of a board game or a card game or a tabletop game, these core elements will always remain the same. Theme is automatically, because I have taken it from a real life situation, the theme could be traveling, trying to reach a destination. That could be a theme. Now, whether you are a tourist or you are a student or you are a first time person who is learning how to drive, or you are in a strange city where you don't understand the language and you have to find your path, तो ऐसे करके कोई भी theme हो सकता है. Goal is to reach your destination. Now the mechanic here is where the creativity part will come in. How do you turn this concept of directions into a game within that grid? So for this one, I haven't made an idea because I was thinking that maybe here we can give more time and then you can spend more time trying to find an idea in this area. So but what came to my mind was again. Because we have taken memory as one part of it, remembering the path, maybe the grid has tokens in them, left, right, you know, straight, reverse, etc. But these tokens are written on cards. They are like square cards with the directions written on them, but they are kept upside down in the grid. They are randomly shuffled and placed here and there. There is a map given to you where you know that if you have to reach from point A to be, suppose there are three people playing with each other and all of them have to reach a point, but everyone is going to take different paths. So I know I have to take straight, take a right, and take a left and go straight again, then maybe take a reverse and you take a U-turn, etc., etc., and then come to my point. So how I have adopted, I thought of adopting the memory part here is in the grid, all those pieces are kept upside down. Every time it's my turn, I get to pick a piece. Suppose let's say I want to move straight, but it says right. So I'll say, I don't want to move. I'll keep it back. But what I'll do is I'll memorize, okay, right वहाँ पर है. Then the next person, suppose the next person has to move right, वो देख लेगा, अच्छा, Austin ने ये उठाया, तो मुझे पता ये right है. So he'll pick up that, right है, I'll move right, and he'll keep it back. And now, as you keep on playing the game, you will have to memorize कि कौन सा direction कहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है grid पे. And then, make sure that you remember the turn, you pick it up and you move your pawn and reach to the destination. Whoever reaches first wins the game. So it's like a quick adopting what you experience in life and adapting that onto a board and turning that into a game. So the challenge here becomes memory because you have to remember kaun se card ke piche kaun sa direction likha hai. The rules are you pick a card, you see it. Either you move or you keep it back. Whoever reaches the end first wins. So, again, you can spend some time, but this is where my overall presentation gets over. And like I said, the four, I think I'll go back to the first, this slide. So this is how you can start thinking of an idea. It could be from a story, it could be from a mechanic, it could be a certain skill that you want to test, or it could be something that you see around you and you want to use that and turn it into a game. But like I said, there is no hard and fast rule. This is how you think of an idea. This is from my experience at NID and at working with students and also my own experience of trying to make games. I felt these are certain things that I have faced this challenge when I was starting out, and now I felt, okay, these are the different ways in which you can initiate that step of starting with an idea. It's just that somewhere you need an inspiration to start off with, and that inspiration can be a story, a mechanic, a skill, or something that you have seen around you. And again, this is also a very essential aspect of board games, is that these are the elements which will always remain constant in whatever you make. For theme, I would specifically like to say it is not necessary that your game should have a theme, but sometimes having a theme makes your game more engaging because it has a story, and whenever you have a story, you connect with it more and you will imagine yourself to be a spy or yourself to be a dragon or yourself to be a king, and that really changes your experience of the game. So yeah, so that's from my side, and I'll be here, I think, if for any questions, for discussion of any ideas till the time we have.
Actually, yeah, that's the thing. I wish we had more time. It's very engaging. I think students are also trying to, you know, work on it, and they will do it. So I think if you're all right, since you have your email ID, they might want to, you know, send some ideas that they have.
I think if they can drop their ideas to me, I can just give a quick reply. Yeah. To them.
Yeah, so I think students would like to do that. So that would be great from your side, because this I wish the time we had more time, because it's really engaging. I might say myself would like to try doing something like this. Is my first time engaging into something like this, and it's very interesting. And I'm very sure even the students found it interesting, because making something in even such short time, like they also found out many ideas, and I am very sure many of them are just shy to speak it out loud. So they might, you know, come one to one and like, you know, try to give their ideas. So that happens many a times. So because I think that if, since you said it is all right with you, that you might get some replies. Or something.
But I'll definitely reply.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Austin. It was great having you here, and I'm very sure even the students loved it.
Thank you for inviting.
Thank you
for this opportunity.
Yes. Thank you.
Bye.